It's not his fault.
And if we get rid of him, then who's going to be protecting his kids?
Mm-hmm.
Why do that? What am I going to say?
First, transparency. I did contact the council. I sent a text message to council president and council vice president. And I said that there was a police involved shooting and that the Mercer County Prosecutor's Office and the New Jersey State Police are in charge of the investigation. I have that right here. people walking around the street. Councilwoman Vaughn is right. Poverty, no jobs, that affects the crime rate. But so is our broken bail reform. Bail reform was designed to keep the minor offender out of jail waiting for extended periods of time for trial. It's failing every urban center in New Jersey and across the nation because it allows for violent criminals to get out very quickly. It allows for the nonviolent offenders or property crime offenders. You have the list of folks on there. Look at the list. There's one guy on there, 16 arrests, 7 felony convictions, 7 of those gun arrests. He's still walking around. He's a violent offender. He's out on the street. We recently had 2 released on bracelets, terror attacks and murders. But you don't want to hear that. You want to blame on my feet. You said nothing when my predecessor was here. I worked here. I worked under her. She came in late, left early, that's when she was here at all.
We have a package on that. We need to swear some of this, but we can't arrest.
for some old guys who have a garage, but we can actually have some of this, and we have. We're addressing that. That has to go to court. So I ask, if you can call for a BCO, why did you call when you were all for drugs the other day?
Wow.
I don't have apparently. Police explorers have to hear by police athletically modify police activities because children aren't just involved in sports anymore.
Right.
The Trenton Rise building is near enough for construction for after hours for kids. The joint operations, the daytime task force. Daytime task force is doing more than just writing summonses and arresting people. They're getting folks that have addictions to the care that they need to get. I'm going to hear 30% for those folks that we get over to the American Rescue Workers. 30% of them have signed in. Most of those folks who are paying I'm addressing downtown. It's not going to happen overnight because they didn't get jacked up overnight. None of the city will provide. It didn't happen overnight. And yes, it is a trend across urban areas. I meet with AJ. I brought this to him. I'm trying to do something about it on that level. Bail reform is a legislative issue. That goes on your side of the table and hiring you, council freeholders, assembly people, Congress. Bail reform, council president, is a serious problem for urban areas. I want you to know that. It allows a criminal to come right back onto the street and do the same thing. This is what we're facing. Please know that as the truth, because you know me. We are undermanned. Yes, we voted for the vote a long time ago, 2005. We had 375 officers in that record of homicides. I know that because I was here. I know that. But the philosophy of the police department under that director was reactive, not proactive. I was here. That's what caused that. I'm trying to bring the proactive mentality back because that's what I've been my whole career. I have to change police culture, 100%. The culture of society has to change. Those two changes are married. They are married together. That's what I'm trying to do with my community outreach. That's why we see more things out there on Facebook that the police department is doing with the community. I increased our community affairs unit for that specific reason. I want to make it very, very large, but I've only been able to hire 23 folks. I hired more, some of them didn't make it in the academy. This time around, I hired 20. One was a lateral transfer in from another department. So I hired 19. 13 of them left in the academy. 6 have walked out for whatever reason. The last time I hired 16, one was 9. And unlike someone put out there, three of those folks were minorities. They're just light skinned both of them.
My cousin.
I am. Bring resolution. Street team is part of that. We brought 2 years of street teams here. The second year for anti violence. Continue in that endeavor. all the time. We will continue. I also instituted something because it has been mentioned by council several times that we believe officers in town to other agencies. They get hired here to do it for themselves. Something I thought of, and it was a thought because of the layoffs. Two officers wanted to come back here, and they couldn't because they were on contract with the agency that they went to when they got laid off. So I researched that. Guess what I did? Every new hire has to sign a contract here to remain here for 4 years. Here with my guys in the street when they're involved in emergency situations.
do have strategies and tactics. That's in the package I sent. With the outside agency health personnel, we'll be doing suits with abandoned buildings, so it's frequently that's what drugs are done for me. That's what attracts crime. With my partners, my fellow directors, we're all intertwined. What the daytime task force does, addicted people, mental health, our local. Abandoned buildings, crime.
Being here personally.
Yes, he can participate in a meeting by electronic video, by audio.
Casting an actual vote.
Yes.
I'm voting no.
That's definitely a no.
Yes.
No.
Councilman Rodriguez?
No.
Oh, my goodness. Yes!
Yes.
No matter now.
Who abstained?
They need the super majority, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have it.
No, they don't have it.
But they're gonna try something, but they sneak us out.
That's my pastor.
It failed, it failed. It failed, the vote failed.